Hey YouTube friends, welcome back to my channel. My name is Amisha Maria, and in this video I'm going to give you my final thoughts on the Style Factor Edge Booster Gel. So I have used this gel a total of 3 times now, and I have some thoughts on it. So I've used it twice for a wash and go, and I used it once for a ponytail, which is, you know, what I have going on right now. And here's what I think. So wash and go, it's a no for me, dog. I honestly hate this gel for a wash and go. I used it twice. The first time I used it, I actually uploaded a video on it. If you haven't seen it, I'll link it above. And at first, while I was doing my hair, I was a little bit like iffy on it. But by the time I finished it, I really did like it. However, the next day, my hair was like so stiff. And the reason for it is because of the texture of this gel. It was hard for me to gauge how much I actually need it for my hair. So the first time I used it, I used like a lot of the product. Way more than what was necessary. So my hair, it had absolutely no volume. I wouldn't say that it was as stiff as if I used like too much of an Eco Styler gel, but it didn't have much movement at all. And like I said, it was no volume. So I ended up that day wearing my hair in like a top knot bun, and it was just so thin. Like, it took out all of the volume. I don't know, it's hard to explain. I wish I would have like took a picture or filmed it. So the next day I was like, all right, well, let me try to use it again and use less. Now when I used less of the product, my hair had more volume, but it was almost like too much volume, to the point to where it only lasted one day. So it was kind of like a lose-lose situation. It was like I used way too much, so I couldn't really wear it down. And then I used not enough, and my hair was like, it looked like I had like a day 4 wash and go on the first day. So yeah, when it comes to wash and goes, it's a no for me. And it could have potential, probably, if I play with it a little more to, you know, see how, if I play with it a little more to figure out like what's the best way to use it, I could probably get a good wash and go. But this thing cost me $15. I don't have time to like do trial and error with wash and goes with this product, just because it costs way too much. The other con that I had with it during the wash and go is that it was very sticky. So I don't know about you, but I personally sweat a lot, especially while I'm sleeping. So a lot of times when I wake up, my hair can be a little more damp, which is also where a good amount of my frizz comes from when I do my wash and goes. Now, because of that, when I take my hair out in the mornings with this product, my hair was sticky. Now, when using this product initially, it is like a sticky consistency, but once it dries, it goes away. However, because of that, if your hair gets just the smallest amount of wetness, the stickiness comes back. So that was another con, because it was like touching my hair when I'm trying to like reshape it and style it again for the next day, it'll be sticky. Don't nobody want to walk around with sticky hair. So That's another reason why this gel is a no for me when it comes to wash and goes. Now, what I will use this gel for is sleek ponytails. This is probably like the sleekest ponytail I have ever gotten, like ever. Usually my hair, when I use like my Eagle Styler or my Wet Lining String Gel, my hair has way more waves than this do, but this is literally the smoothest I have ever got in my hair. So I say this is definitely a win. So what I'm thinking about doing is just for right now sticking with like my Wet Line and sticking with my Eco for my wash and goes, but I will definitely use this and repurchase this for when I want to do sleek, slick buns, ponytails, puffs, anything where I need my hair to lay down really nicely. I definitely will use this for, and for that I honestly don't mind spending $15 for it, because for one, I don't wear my hair back often, so I won't go through it, you know, as quickly as I would if I was just using this for wash and goes. And also I think if it's going to give me such good results, I'm willing to spend the money for it. So all in all, I will not use this gel for any type of like styling when it comes to wash and goes, puffs, like if I actually have to put it on my puff, absolutely not. Anywhere where my hair is out, I will not use this product. However, I will use this for any sleek, slick down hairstyles that I want to do, such as puffs, ponytails, buns, etc. So yeah, that is my thoughts on the Style Factor Edge Booster Gel. Please comment down below if you've tried this product and how you like it. If you have the same opinions as me, or if you actually do like it for your wash and goes, let me know down below. Don't forget to give this video a thumbs up and also hit the subscribe button so you can see all of my future videos that I upload. And I will see you in the next one, guys. Bye.